Hello, welcome to the Best Wines Online Tasting Room. And it just so happened, as we were running through the queue of all the suppliers and everyone grooving our way this way, we actually bumped into a very special guest that we knew we had to get on camera the minute he walked in the door. I'd like to introduce you to Frédéric Bernier, who is the new... What is your exact title? Let's start there.
We call in your language winemaker.
Winemaker,
because it's the word we are using. We are in your country. In fact, it's a little bit more large as a winemaker because we're taking care of the vineyard. We're taking care about the wine until the bottling. We have to defend the wines in front of people, customers, journalists. So it's more as a winemaker, we have to defend it. It's like a baby, so we have to taking care about that. And of course, we have many relationships with different kind of people, the growers, the people who are selling some grapes, because as you know, we have a different position. We have some vineyards we own directly. And we have to buy some grapes sometimes because we cannot own all Burgundy. It's not possible. Jadot, it's a large company. That's right, but it's not possible to own all Burgundy. So we need to create good relationship with some growers and to convince them to sell us some grapes, good grapes, in good conditions, picked at the right moment. So it takes a long time to have these relationships with them.
Okay, so I would like to introduce you formally then. To the new winemaker, grape buyer, political advisor, vineyard walker, master of the cellar, spokesperson, supermodel, Frédéric Bernier from Louis Jadot. And Frédéric actually just recently took over, I guess technically, for the recently technically retired Jacques Lardière, who was known throughout Burgundy-dom as one of the bastions of great Burgundy winemaking during his tenure at Louis Jadot. Although Frédéric has been at Jadot for an extended period of time, right?
Yeah, I joined Jadot in 2010.
So 2010, okay.
2010, beginning of 2010. So we spent together with Jacques 3 years together, three vintages.
Mm-hmm.
We did, it was the idea, to did 2010, 2011, 2012 together. And now officially get retired, so it's a step in the transition, but he's not so far from my shoulder. He has now a position of consultant, so it means that we still taste together, and he's not so far if I'm a little bit in trouble and I have some questions. So but that's true, it's very important for me and for everybody and for him too, because it was his passion, and it's absolutely necessary to continue this transition and this relationship we had together, and we will continue to have that together.
Now this job description, which was essentially everything, I don't know if you caught that, it was, he does basically everything. Some of it is time sensitive. Like for example, when you get halfway through a harvest, say a harvest like, you know, 2011 or 2012, and you know the vintage conditions, you know the fact that you're gonna have to maybe start making some phone calls, like a few months into the harvest, you understand the question? Like there's a lot of work happens later on, correct? Like even though you think you have everything all lined up, you have your contracts lined up, you have the negociant contracts lined up, but as you go through the process, once in a while you can be, as Mother Nature gives you what it's going to give you, maybe there's some phone calls that you have to make later in the harvest. So it's a tough job, isn't it?
Yes, it is a tough job. It is a tough job, but of course we are not alone to do that. Huh? We have a team, there is people around that. We have a very nice team in the vineyard. We have a contact in the vineyard to make the relationship with the growers. We are not alone. We have people in the cellar, people everywhere. So we cannot do what we are trying to do alone. It's not possible. We need a good team. And the team is nice. The team is efficient. They know very well what they have to do. For some of it, they are working for a long time for Maison Louis Jadot, so they know the philosophy, they know the idea. So, it's not absolutely not possible to do that alone. We are here to manage that, to help them to take the good decision. But alone, it's not possible to manage a producer like Maison Louis Jadot. So But that's right. Yes, it's a lot to do. But it's that's the challenge. That's that's why I'm here.
Yeah.
It's to take the job and to do the job. And but it's of course it's a challenge. Yeah. Mm.
Previously, were you doing some of the same types of things before you got to Louis Jadot in 2010?
I spent 10 years for another producer.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
I worked 10 years for another producer. I think that my philosophy in the work is really to be loyal. So I started with my other producer when I arrived in Burgundy in 1999. I stayed 10 years and I just moved for Maison Louis Jadot. Everybody will understand why, because it's a dream for a guy like me to access to a producer like Maison Louis Jadot, and especially to work with Jacques.
Yeah.
So it was for me a beautiful step to. In my life, so of course, and I hope I will stay. time.
Well, you know, if your first vintage is any indication, I think you might be there for a while.
Yeah.